42 blasphemy cases registered in Pakistan in the last 30 days. This is intense. So, at least 42 cases pertaining to blasphemy were registered across Pakistan in a single month, according to data compiled by a social media user. Most of those accused of blasphemy belong to the Shia community, who have been booked under 295A and 298 sections of the Pakistan Penal Code for allegedly insulting the companions of the Prophet Muhammad. Up to 80 people are known to be imprisoned in Pakistan on blasphemy charges, half of whom face life in prison or the death penalty, according to the United States Commission on International Religious Freedom. So I wanted to highlight
that is crazy. Like, guys, this is just to be clear, just before Susanna, this is like, I just want to clarify, this is huge, but even this is crazy by Pakistani standards, even by 42 blasphemy cases in just 30 days. Like, people are going, like, this is blasphemy on steroids. Like, this is like the reason this is because Pakistan is getting more and more crazy with its blasphemy accusations, and it's working. Like, that's why people are using it as a weapon. People are going left and right accusing each other of blasphemy, because it just, as soon as you accuse, like, they take it seriously, your life is threat. Like, you could legally threaten people's lives by accusing them of blasphemy, and you are actually putting people in great danger by doing that, or and at least putting them in a lot of hardship and misery and legal, you know, getting them involved in the legal system, and, you know, getting their job. This is so effed up in so many ways, and it's getting worse. Like, Pakistan is one of those countries that is constantly getting worse. But go on, sorry, Susanna.
One of the reasons why I wanted to highlight this is because, by the way, I encourage everyone, the sources for the news we cover is in the description, and in this news article, you can go find this thread. So I'm looking at it on my computer. Well, you can't see, but it's huge. Like, the amount of cases registered is crazy. Look, it just keeps going. It just keeps going. And the reason why I wanted to highlight this is because, obviously, blasphemy has been in the media a lot in our world of monitoring these situations, especially over the past few months, beginning in April with the imprisonment and disappearance of Mubarak Bala. There's another case we're going to cover as our last news, and the desecration of the Quran, Charlie Hebdo. It's extremely prevalent theme right now. And we're often talking about it in terms of how blasphemy harms secularists and atheists. Blasphemy laws harm religious people. They harm all people. They persecute religious minorities. I am an atheist and an anti-theist who fights for and I fight against the persecution of religious minorities, okay? And this is a huge source of oppression of all people, including religious minorities. Now, this is being used against Shia people, coming after them in droves. This is a huge problem, especially because in this country and in that culture, the mere allegation of it can have a mob sent after you to be lynched. The police had to let Asia Bibi go in the middle of the night to escape out of the country because they knew that they were coming after her. They have murdered governors and ministers who were defending people accused of alleged blasphemy. Okay, and so we need to stand with the people of Pakistan, all people of Pakistan, in helping create a culture where these laws can be repealed, because they harm everyone. That's just one of the many things I have to say about it, but you guys go ahead. Are you muted?
Hold on. Yes, sorry. Susanna, what are you saying about this? Sankalp is saying Hindus will love to share this news to prove their point for their hatred for Pakistan, while India uses sedition laws to oppress dissent. What do you think about that?
Well, India has their own blasphemy laws, and we would know because people are currently filing police charges against Armin for blasphemy. So
No, I think it's not comparable. Like, Pakistan is like way, 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 way worse than India. We can call out India for any challenges to secularism. I mean, India is still, but secularism in India is still, you know, way ahead of Pakistan, right? So it's not a competition. Like, we could point out the problems in India, we could point out the problems in Pakistan without actually suggesting that they are the same, right? Rivka, you wanted to say something?
Yeah, I was going to say, too, that the blasphemy charges aren't even necessarily important for people often to even get them in court, even though they may file them. What's important is it creates this mob mentality, and it gives this unbelievable amount of extrajudicial power to the person who makes the charge. Then the whole community feels entitled to then act on that charge. Okay. And you know, we saw that happen in the court where that young man was murdered in court. Registering the charge, that in and of itself, I even don't even think is the main thing. The main thing is just saying it. And once you put it out there, it takes on its life of its own. And you have this mob violence that can happen. And it's almost as if the charge itself is some sort of weapon that's being wielded. And if you're doing it because you really believe this blasphemy, if you're doing it because you've got a vendetta against someone, it doesn't matter. It's like a cudgel or a sword that you're wielding, and other people will pick it up and start, you know, wielding it too.
Right. Yes, actually, I wanted to highlight this one. This one was very interesting. Binary skeptic saying Pakistan updated its blasphemy laws recently, which includes talking shit about Muhammad's companions. Yes, that's going to actually. This is an anti-Shia law. Actually, we have a news about that, right? We're going to get into that, or is that next week? Susanna, you're muted. I think that's next week.
A large part of this is that Shias are in the past 42 cases in the past 30 days, Shias are overwhelmingly overrepresented for insults to the Sahaba.
Yeah, because again, the Sahaba, the Muhammad's companions, the Shias hate them, the Sunnis love them. So now apparently insulting them is also now blasphemy in Pakistan. So this has opened the door for the Sunnis to go after the Shias in Pakistan. Some people are actually, unfortunately, some people that are anti-blasphemy are celebrating this, unfortunately, because they think this is just poetic justice because the Shias were, the Shias and Sunnis were uniting and putting blasphemy charges on other minority groups in Pakistan. So now that they basically all of that is established, now the Sunnis are like, okay, now it's your turn, and they're turning in the Shias. And the Shias are like, oh my, like, so a lot of people are like, well, this, you get what you deserve. That's what, but I don't think that's fair because that's collective punishment. And also, you know, yeah. So, and nobody deserves to be, you know, blasphemy laws are bad. Okay, guys, blasphemy laws are bad. Okay. So, don't support it just because you think it's poetic justice or anything like that. Rivka?
I was just going to say, it's almost like this, like mental or spiritual North Korea, right? So it's keeping people from thinking, or they can think whatever they want, rather, but from saying or doing anything, because they're afraid that their neighbor could accuse them of blasphemy. There was a police officer that charged someone, you know, or registered charges. There's, you know, school teachers, court authorities, average people, you know, anybody down the street. So there's this thing that, like, the space between what you think and what you can say or do is so large. It's like this giant, you know, Southeast Asia, spirit, you know, mental North Korea.
Chris is saying, unlike Pakistan, the people and the government will kill you for insulting Islam. I don't know what you mean. I don't know what that means, but I think that in Pakistan is the difference between Pakistan and countries like Iran and Saudi Arabia is that in Iran and Saudi Arabia, it's the government that you need to be worried about the most. In Pakistan, it's the mob, the people that you need to be worried about the most. Sometimes getting arrested in Pakistan is the best way to survive, unfortunately. San Kalp is saying secularism is in danger in India as long as the current government stays in power. Yes. And they passed an anti-secular law just a few years back, sharing related videos on Discord. Thank you, San Kalp. Our Discord server, link to our Discord server is in the description. There's a channel in our Discord server called Video Recommendations. If you post videos there, I will look at them and I will consider them for reviewing on our daily live streams. It was a two-part comment. Sorry, Chris, if I didn't get it. Sorry. All right. Thank you for joining us. Subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell thingy. If you haven't, I don't know why. What's holding you back? Okay. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, why haven't you subscribed to our channel? Explain that to us, please. Like, bell, and also, if you're not getting notifications and stuff because YouTube is not telling people that we have shows, because YouTube is like, oh, this person told us that they want to get your shows, right? They want to get your videos, but nah, we think it's no. And look, oh, they also hit the bell button, but nah, you guys are too controversial. We want to show them mainstream stuff. We want to show them CNN or cat videos or whatever. But even there are people like, no, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we don't think you want this. We're like, no, please show it to us. We say to you, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we think we know what's better for you than you yourself. So to solve that, there's a link in the description, which is to our newsletter. So hopefully we could email it to you. So hopefully you get some of our content that way. Okay. So yeah. Subscribe to our newsletter as well. And share our videos, because, you know, we do get demonetized. That's an obvious on every one of our videos. So F that, but we don't care about that anymore. But we also get deprioritized, and that's even more damaging to us. Deprioritized. What does that mean? That means we don't show up on the suggested, you know, videos on the right and all that, you know, on people's homepages. And that's how channels grow. Unfortunately, we can't grow. So we need you guys to share our videos. So